Good morning, students. Today we are going to start the new chapter, Control and Coordination. I hope you have learnt about reflex action, reflex arc. Okay. After this, I am going to tell you about the major topic of this chapter, that is the brain. Okay. Just brain is under the human nervous system. So let's talk about the human brain. Before we are going for the brain, we go for a quick flow chart to explain about the brain under which systems. Okay. Now, human brain. Today we are going to start human brain. The human nervous system is divided into two parts beta. It is a short abbreviated from HNS. The human nervous system is divided into two parts. Human nervous system CNS and PNS. बेटा और बुक में PNS के बाद ANS भी दे रखा है बट यू मस्ट रिमेंबर दैट PNS ANS इज कम अंडर PNS अगेन आई एम रिपीटिंग द HNS ह्यूमन नर्वस सिस्टम इज कम अंडर CNS एंड PNS सो CNS इज सेंट्रल नर्वस सिस्टम एंड PNS इज पेरिफेरल नर्वस सिस्टम नाउ सेंट्रल नर्वस सिस्टम इज फर्दर डिवाइडेड इंटू टू पार्ट्स brain and spinal cord. Let's talk about the brain. Brain and spinal cord, they are come under which system? CNS. And CNS come under which system? HNS. Okay. Come to the contrast, PNS, peripheral nervous system. They are divided into two parts, VNS and ANS. VNS and ANS. VNS, voluntary nervous system. I'm writing here voluntary nervous system and ANS autonomous nervous system so PNS is further divided into two part VNS and ANS VNS again divided into following two parts cranial nerves and spinal nerves and ANS is divided into again two further part sympathetic and parasympathetic they work antagonistically to each other we'll talk further on this so let's focus on the brain okay the brain is further divided into three major parts forebrain midbrain hindbrain again I'm repeating brain is divided into following parts forebrain midbrain and hindbrain the forebrain has two major part cerebrum and olfactory lobe which are there in the nose cerebrum the largest part of the brain and the olfactory lobes come to the midbrain contain two part corpora quadrigemina repeat after me corpora quadrigemina and the second one is cerebral aqueduct now come to the last that is hindbrain contain three major parts cerebellum this is cerebrum which is there in the forebrain this is cerebellum also known as little brain pons veduli and the last one is or medulla oblongata in which after ending it start the spinal cord so this is about the flow chart of a brain human nervous system is further divided into cns and pns today our topic is brain so brain are come under which system central nervous system under which system my dear tell me central nervous system excellent So my dear, this is the structure of the brain. So let's talk about beta. This is the structure of the brain. Okay, so we have a largest part known as cerebrum. Then we have a corpus callosum, which is a part of the midbrain. Then we have a thalamus. Under, just below the thalamus, we have hypothalamus. The master gland is known as pituitary gland. Then these are the parts of hindbrain, pons veruli, medulla oblongata and cerebellum, also known as the little brain. So in this topic we are going to learn the structure, the whole structure of the brain. Okay, so central nervous system, CNS system. Actually, central nervous system, it includes brain and spinal cord. It is covered by axial skeleton, okay, and lies on the mid part along the main axis of the body. If I talk about CNS, also known as central nervous system, is a site of information processing and control and act as a command and control system. So it is a processing and control and act as a command and control system. The command and control system, because it include brain and spinal cord, and brain is the highest coordinating center. It control all the voluntary movements, the movement which are in our control. It also regulate body balance, the body posture, the body equilibrium of your body, thermoregulations, hunger, bhook lagna, thirst, pyaas lagna, function of several endocrine glands. The ductless gland, also known as endocrine glands, play a vital role for specific functions and human behavior. So just imagine, CNS system is one of the vital system that maintain and control approximately all the movements, because it contain brain. Yes, we have done right now that CNS, central nervous system, has divided into two parts, spinal cord and brain. Now we talk about brain. In the scientific way, we call brain is also known as encephalon. Repeat after me. Encephalon. Okay, and there is a to find out the brain activity we have an instrument known as EEG. Like heart we have ECG, heart ke liye cardio, yani heart ki activity ko find out karne ke liye we have an instrument known as ECG, electrocardiograph, or gram you can say that. Same as in brain, to find out the electrical activity, to find out the electrical records of the brain, we have an instrument known as EEG. EEG is also known as electroencephalograph. So encephalon, the word stands for the brain. Okay, now brain is the highest coordinating center, as I told you, and it is present at the anterior most part. Anterior, I mean front part of the nervous system. Now how it looks? It is soft and whitish organ. Weight approximately 1220 to 1440 gram. It varies according to male and female. It is about very important for the accommodation of 100 billion neurons. Agar aap beta is diagram ko dekhenge, we have various convoluted structure. We have various convoluted structures inside the brain. And why this convoluted structure is so important? Because for the accommodation of more and more neurons. And we know that, you have learned that neuron is a unit of nervous system, and it play a vital role to receive and send the messages in the form of chemical and electrical means. Now, the brain is further divided into three parts. The forebrain, also known as prosencephalon. Pros means first. Forebrain, midbrain, mesencephalon, and the hindbrain, which is the last one, is known as rhombencephalon. So let's talk about, my dear student, prosencephalon, also known as forebrain. It consists of olfactory lobes. So my dear, what is olfactory lobe? Which is there in the nose, which is responsible for the sensing of smell, actually these nerves receive impulses. Impulses, it means messages. So let's talk about the olfactory lobes, as I told you, it receives impulses from the olfactory receptors, receptor that who receive the impulses, that who receive the messages. Cells in the nose and are responsible for the sensation of smell. So olfactory lobes, it is the uppermost part of the brain and made up of a pair of, they are two in number, made up of a pair of short club-shaped structure. A pair of olfactory nerve arise from the olfactory lobes, because in the lobes we have a nerves that receive and act as a receptor that receive the cells in the nose which are responsible for the sensation of smell. Now, what is the main function of these olfactory lobes which are there in the forebrain and which are pair in number and which are present in the uppermost part of the brain? Beta, these nerves receive impulses. As I told you number of times, ye nerves kya karti hai? Ye impulses, yani messages ko receive karti hai. Kis messages ko receive karti hai? Sensation of smelling ke liye. Because they are present in the nose. They are present in the nose. So let's talk about the cerebrum in the next video. Thank you.